If you check the website, you will see like I posted two chapters for today. It's a lot of stuff for today. So take a look at the website though.
I graded your midterm, so I think the average is above 90, so everybody did quite well. The final will be the same kind of setting. I'll send you guys the multiple choice questions for the final and give you a weekend to work on it. So, and yeah, I received a couple of emails asking me for like a couple of questions, right? 26. Catherine got it. Yeah, do you want to explain to us for question number 6? 26?
Oh, 26.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And not 6.
Yes, off the top of my head here.
Yeah.
That one was very challenging. Let me pull up my cheat sheet here. Where I did it on Excel. But I ended up finding, let's see, midterm, here it is. Okay, for 26, here it is. If I'm not, I ended up finding the EPR, I mean not EPR, EIR, the earned, and then she had made a note in 26, if I'm not mistaken,
yeah,
that it said the EAR is equal to the APR. Do you remember that? So when I discovered the EAR, I used, I have effect is equal to 8.75%, 12. Let's see. 8.75%, because this was biennium, right? Hang on, let me grab my folder. You hit me off guard here.
I don't know the number, but you just need to, once you got you should use the rate function. You should use the rate function and get use the rate function to get the YTM, yield to maturity. And this is just the APR. This is just like your annual return in a year was compounded twice.
Yes.
So, and then you should use EAR, effect function to get the EAR. This will be your yield to maturity for another bond, which is paying the annual coupon. And then you should use this EAR as the new YTM, and then figure out the new price. If I still remember this question well, I think this is a question for asking for the price, right? Mm. Asking for the new price.
Yes. What is the price of the annual coupon bond?
Yeah.
Yet the two bonds should offer the same annual effective rate, not semi rate.
Yeah. So it's just like your rate function. What you got is half of the years.
Mm-hmm.
Half year's rate. So your ITM is this half year rate times 2. But this is not your, that's why this is just the APR here. So if you do this, what you got is the APR, but you want to get this EAR for this. You're getting that, this is your return in half of the year, but how in the whole year, how much is your return? That's EAR. So you need to use the effect function,
mm-hmm.
Effect function to get this EAR.
Yes.
To get this EAR. And once you got this EAR, this will be your YTM in the new equation.
Mm-hmm.
And then this will be your new bond with annual coupon.
Yes.
And use this new YTM in this. Everything else is the same except you need to calculate the price. So you use the PV function to get the new price. So that's a couple of the students is asking me for how to work out this problem. So this is this one. Yeah. Any other questions from the midterm? And the final is going to be covering chapter 8. To chapter 8, 9, 10, 13, and chapter 2 and chapter 3. So we will do two chapters today. We've done chapter 8. Chapter 8 is stock pricing. So this is, now we are going to do, to study two new chapters, chapter 9 and chapter 10 today. So, but however, it's not that difficult. You see, you can find the calculator. One is IRR and APR, IRR and MPV calculator. And the concepts are not, new. Also, another one is called Weighted Average Cost of Capital, WACC. And I have two calculators here. You can use it as your reference. So these are the two chapters. So let's start with the new chapter, Capital Budgeting. And the kind of questions you can use the concept of capital budgeting to answer is just like, for example, you want to open a restaurant nearby, and then so, how much money you think you can make from your new project, from your new investment, or your new business plan, and that's capital budgeting. You have limited resources. You have limited capital, and you're thinking about to get the best results from your investment. So what can you do? You can, just like a business owner, you can figure out how much money you can make year by year. For example, you can figure out the cash you can earn every year is how much until like you close the business in your future. The business will be closed. So you can figure out every year how much money you can make, and you can figure out how much is your borrowing cost. For example, you have friends who can provide you some money, and you can go to the bank and borrow money. So you can consider like how you can raise the capital, and you can figure out the cost is how much. And that's your discount rate. That's your discount rate. And then so if you discount the money you are getting in the future by the borrowing cost, and then that will be how much money you feel like you can, how much is worth of the new investment. It's just like you know how much money you can make from your new investment, from your new project, and you also know how much does it cost for you to raise the capital. So the MPV, if you do this calculation like this was doing, if you do this calculation, the MPV, net present value, will be the worth of your project, right? It's just like you come to JU, and it costs you some money to attend JU, and then but however you will be making more money in the future. So you consider about like the money you'll be, the additional money you'll be you'll be making after your education is from JU, and then you discount it at a certain rate, and then you consider the cost you spend by attending JU, and that will be the net worth of like your education from JU, right? So it's just this kind of way of thinking. So it's capital budgeting. So for chapter 9, what will be given will be that like the cash flows in the future, the projected cash flows will be given, the discount rate will be given. Discount rate is chapter 14. Chapter 14, we will be using weighted average cost of capital equation to figure out the cost of capital or the discount rate in capital budgeting questions. This is the equation to get the MPV. This R is the discount rate. So you see, so it's really, the calculations is just this equation here. The CF1 from this equation, CF1, CF2, CFN, are like the cash flow or money you can earn from your investment. And by discounting by this R is just a discount rate. And this MPV would be the net worth of your new project. Or like you attending JU, this is the net worth of your JU experience, JU education worth. So this is a general idea for capital budgeting. So it's just like somebody asks you, give the evaluation of a project or evaluate your like education at JU. So what you can do, you can just figure out how much additional income you can make from because of your education. And then you get the net present value of the additional incomes you're getting in the future and subtract the cost to attend JU, and that will be your net worth of your JU education. That's the NPV, net present value. So the basic concept is just like that. See, today we will be learning how to calculate the NPV, and also from chapter 14, we are going to be learning how to calculate this R. R is weighted average cost of capital or discount rate. So to evaluate the project, what you can do is you can either figure out like how much is the net worth by considering the incomes from the new project, subtract the initial cost for that project. That will be the net worth. NPV is just like net worth of this project, right? So this is a one approach. And there's another approach. It's called IRR approach. You can also use IRR to evaluate the project. IRR is just like, this is the discount. This is a general equation here. But IRR is the break-even rate. For example, you have different ways to raise capital. Like you can raise capital from the bank. But bank give you, for example, 10% of 10% of the interest rate they charge. And for example, you can raise money from your parents. They only charge you 5%. But if you plug in 10% into this NPV equation, you realize your NPV is negative, for example, and your cost of capital is too high. And if you plug in 5%, for example, by borrowing money from your parents and your NPV is positive, then you'll be happy because NPV is positive means you're making money from this. It's just like you attend JU, you have some student loans. If you can get it really cheap, it will make your like values from your education here more valuable. Yeah, if your student loans is too high, well, you probably think, I'd better not attend JU to get education because the cost of attending JU is too high. So this R is it's a cost of capital, but there's a special rate will make you break even, make this NPV equals to zero. It's just like you attend to JU, there's a rate, like student loan rate, make you break even. If you get student loan rate higher than this, you will be losing money. You will be thinking about, again, whether or not to attend to you. But if you can borrow money lower than this break-even rate, and it's a wise decision to attend JU, that sort of thing. So there is a specific R here that will make this NPV equals to zero. And that rate is called IRR rate. So you can use this IRR rate to make your business capital budgeting decisions. This is like at this rate, if you borrow money, if you attend JU with a student loan at this rate, you break even. If the student loan is lower than this, you're better off. You're getting more money from your education. If you get it higher than this rate, and you'll be losing money, you'd better not to come. So this is another approach. NPV tells you how much is the net worth or net loss from your this capital budgeting decision. IRR is just like it tells you like the highest borrowing cost, highest cost of capital you should be getting. If you get more higher than this IRR rate, and your cost is too high. So, but by only comparing at the rate, at the interest rate, this is another way to do that. Yeah. So PI is similar. PI stands for profitable index. So instead of getting the NPV, NPV is the dollar amount, but PI is the ratio. So you just add up all your incomes you're getting from this project by divided by its cost. CF0 is the cost of the project. CF1 from CFT are your future incomes. So you're getting the ratio of the benefits, all these are the benefits over the cost. That's your profitable index. So if your profitable index is higher than one, and that means this is a good business decision. You should take this project. So this is another way. And modified MIR is similar to IRR. This is also a ratio. And also there is another approach. So we are going to be like using five approach to do this capital budgeting evaluation. So the fifth one is called payback period. This is a general equation. You just figure out how much is the cost, and then add up all the incomes you're getting from this project. And then, but you figure out how long does it take for you to pay back your loans. So that's the payback period approach. So that's all for this chapter. Sounds easy, right? Sounds easy. Yeah, so any concepts like you have problem with? So do you have some problem with like what's NPV and why we should be using NPV to evaluate the project? NPV is a net worth. It's a dollar amount net worth. So you think about how much is the cost, and think about how much are the future incomes, and then you figure out how much is the borrowing cost for your capital, and then so you consider all these factors and calculate the NPV, net present value. NPV is positive, and that means this project future income are more than the cost. So it's a good project. NPV is zero, and means you break even. NPV is negative, and means your future incomes are not sufficient to cover your cost. So you should let this project go. It's not a good business to start to think about. So IR is just a rate. You can use IR function. IR, and there's a function under Excel. This is a syntax. This is IR. NPV also has a function in Excel. Also, you can do MIRR, PI, profitable index. There's no Excel equation, but it's not so difficult to do. Payback period, you have to do that, calculate it by hand. Okay, so, or you can use this calculator. For example, let's just give it a try here. We're not using EAA here, but we're using NPV, IRR, and payback in this case. For example, if you are using this calculator, so cash flow is how much cost. If it's year zero, that's a cost. For example, it is $1,000 project, and for example, the first year cash flow. The first year income is 400, second year, for example, is 300, third year is say 500. The frequency is just like this cash flow repeated for how many times? Okay, so if it's repeated for one time, you just put one there. So and this cash flow table means we're spending $1,000 for year one's cash flow. We're getting $400 back in year one, $300 back in year two, $500 back in year three here. And cost of capital, for example, let's use 10%. And that's all. So okay, so we're not using this EAA. So can you explain to me what this result means? So we know what this table means, but this is cost of capital, and that means you raise your capital at 10%. Some people charge you 10% for interest to provide you $1,000 for your project. So you borrow $1,000 at 10%. Let's use this 10%. And then, so your NPV is negative 12.77.
So that's a horrible idea.
Yeah, so it's negative, and that means you, even though you add up your future incomes is how much? 1,200, right? 1,200, but it's not enough because you have to pay back 10% of interest to the lenders. So it's not enough to pay back to cover your expenses at year zero. So this is a horrible business idea. Yeah, so IR is 9.3%. So when you compare this IR, this is, remember, this is the highest cost of capital you should be getting to break even. You see, if you put this 9.3, if you put this cost of capital equals to 9.3, how much is the MPV? Zero. Yeah, see, let's calculate, it's zero. Yeah, so if we put 10%, this cost of capital is too high. So the higher is the break-even cost of capital should be 9.3. If you can get the money under 9.3% of interest, so and that means you will be getting some money back from your investment, from your money. For example, if you put 6%, your MPV will be positive. Okay. MPV is positive, but if it's beyond 9.3, let's say 11, so your MPV will be negative. Yeah, so see, this is IR. This is what the IR means. 9.3% is the highest cost of capitals. Now let's do the 2.6 payback period. This payback period is not changing with cost of capital. For example, it's 2.6. If we put cost of capital like 1%, it's still 2.6%. But the MPV will be much, much higher. IR will not be changed. But MPV is going up. It's going, MPV will go, if you put different cost of capital, MPV will be a different number. But IR will be the same. If you have the same table for cash flows, the IR will be the same. The payback period will be the same. Now, let's calculate this payback. Why it's 2.6? Is that really 2.6? Let's do the calculation. Well, we can work it in our head here. So the cost is $1,000, right? So you make $400 in year one. After year one, how much is your debt? How much you still owe to the lender? 600, yeah. After the second year? 300. After the, well, you only owe $300 in, but after year two. So year three, you make $500. So it's only the 0.6 portion, 60% of the year three. You need to use 60% of your time in year three to pay back to your loan. So that's why the answer is 2.6. It's just the first year, the complete second year, and 0.6 of your third year. You need to pay back to your debt. So the answer is 2.6. So that's how you calculate it for payback. You just think about like how much you will be break even, and at that time, and that time will be your payback period. You count from the beginning to that time, and that will be your payback period. So in this case, it's 2.6. So how much is PI? Profitable index. PI you use, how much is PI? For example, let's still use 10%. PI's equation is this. Here, this is PI. This one. Or the present value from year one, year two, year three. And the net present value from year one, two, and three. And then you divide it by $1,000, that will be your PI. The MPV is you get the present value from year one, two, and three, and you add the year zero's cash flow, and that's your MPV. The PI should be how much is your PI? Let me do this here. Okay, so let's do PI here. So PI's equation should be, profitable index should be, NPV of cash flow 1 to cash flow 3 and divided by cash flow 0, but it has to be absolute value. So so NPV of cash flow 1 to cash flow 3 should be how much? So we're using 10%. So here, right? So remember, cash flows, NPV function, we start from year one's cash flow. And so PI should be 987.23 divided by 1,000. So here, this should be the PI. So you see, so the NPV of cash flow, we're doing cash flow from 0 to cash flow 3. This is NPV. And so it should be NPV function, we're using 10%. But this is from year 0 to year 3, so you should subtract 1,000. So this is NPV. So this is NPV here, and this is PI. PI equals to 1. You know, PI is a ratio. PI under 1, and that means this is a bad project. PI under 1 means your cash flow, you add up the cash flows from year 1 to year 3, it's not enough to cover your expenses at year 0 if PI is under 1. So if you want to evaluate the project, you want the PI to be higher than 1, NPV to be positive. So that's PI. So it's similar to PI, is just getting the ratio of all your incomes in the future years divided by your cost. NPV is the dollar amount of difference between your future incomes and your initial cost. So it's the same concept. So the payback period is 2.6. And the IRR, how to get the IRR in Excel? Like, let's say, this is, we know our cash flow. What you can do to get the IRR, you can either use the calculator, but you should try the Excel. If you do Excel, you should create a table like this. But you should start from year 0. This is the cash flow table. This is it. We don't need to get IR, we don't need the discount rate, we don't need the R here. So this is our cash flow. So you see year zero's cost is $1,000, and then your incomes from this project are $400, $300, $500. So what you can do is you can use this IR function. You can find it under formula financial, or simply just type equals to IRR and then highlight all the cash flows from year 1, year 0 to year 3. And here's the answer, 9.3. Yeah, so the equation is very simple. But you have to start from year 0's. You see, if you use MPV, use this table to get the MPV, you need the R, which is 10%. Also, you need to start from year one to year three. And then you add year zero. So it's different. IR, you should start from year zero to year three. But for MPV, you start from year one. In the function, I should add year zero. So it should be 12.79 here. So this is different. So this is IR, this is MPV here. Yeah, to do the payback period, so you just have to just do that year by year until you figure out at what time you don't owe anything anymore. You paid completely. Your debt is all gone. So and then you figure out at what time and you can make it happen and then add up all the years it take to get to here, and that will be your payback period. So, and there's another one. It's called PI, profitable index. If we use profitable index, it just equals to MPV 10%. If you use this table, divided by 1,000. It has to be positive. PI has to be a positive number. So for payback, so it should be, we did it, 2.6 years is the payback period. And the last one is modified IRR. For the IRR, you can go to formula, go to financial. So you see IRR here. This is a function. So, and from here, you can just use this table and incorporate all the cash flows from year one. Oh, no, it's wrong. Should be this, from year zero. From year zero, yeah. And then here, you can leave it blank, or you can put a number. For example, you think it's IR should be around, for example, 2%. So you can put the 2% or whatever, or you can just leave it just like it is. So you see the answer it's given you at 9.3%. But anyhow, you can use that function in Excel to do that. That's IR. And there's another one, it's called modified IR. Well, let's watch a video about what this modified IR is. You see, so in this case, we're assuming when we're doing this IR, we're getting $400 income, and we're assuming like from